Feeling Boss.
Syracuse versus Villanova
is brought to you by Gillette and the revolutionary Gillette Sensor Shaving System. Gillette, the best a man can get. By Nissan, built for the human race. And by Diet Pepsi. Shoot for the great taste of Diet Pepsi. Diet Pepsi, the right one.
Back at the Spectrum here in Philadelphia, a crowd of about 17,000 on hand to see if Villanova can make it two straight over the Orange Men. Tonight's starting lineup brought to you by Sears Die Hard. Here's Al Elia.
Good evening. Welcome to Philadelphia, and welcome to the Spectrum as the Big East Conference presents tonight's game between the Syracuse University Orange Men and the Villanova University Wildcats. Starting at guard for Syracuse, a 5'11 freshman from Voorhees, New Jersey, number 12, Michael Edwards. For Villanova, a 5'11 sophomore from Houston, Texas, number 15, Chris Walker. For Syracuse, a 6'4 senior from Los Angeles, California, number 32, Stephen Thompson. For Villanova, a 6'6 sophomore from Rochester, New York, number 24, Greg Woodard. At center for Syracuse, a 6'10 junior from Tustin, California, number 25, LaRon Ellis. For Villanova, a 6'9 sophomore from Howell, New Jersey, number 32, Mark Daldell. At forward for Syracuse, a 6'10 senior from Detroit, Michigan, number 44, Derek Coleman. For Villanova, a 6'6 freshman from Ridgewater, New Jersey, number 14, Lance Miller. For Syracuse, a 6'9 sophomore from Carlisle, Pennsylvania, number 30, Billy Owens. And for Villanova, a 6'6 freshman from Hayward, California, number 21, Kelvin Burns.
And the coaches, of course, familiar names. Jim Boeheim, 14th season at Syracuse. Great winning percentage. And Rolly Massimino at the helm of Villanova tonight, looking for that upset. Big Monday about to begin here at the Spectrum. We'll be back with the tip in just a minute.
Oh, they've won six straight.
And that loss, as I said off the top, the worst home loss ever at the Carrier Dome for the Syracuse Orange.
Of course, if you talk to Boeheim, Billy Owens, one of the main reasons, I think, is defense as well and the insertion of the guard.
Villanova has struggled at home this year, but their field goal defense has been great. And there is the 6'9 sophomore who has really turned it around. He was in a streak, Bill. We talked about it before in those first five Big East games. I've never seen a player that good play so badly for so long.
And they found themselves. They really did. You have to admire how they've turned it around. I guess Michael Edwards has to be the reason, regardless of what Jim Boeheim says.
Michael Edwards, the freshman guard at the point. LaRon Ellis and Calvin Bird are set to go up. Two freshmen, three sophomores on the floor for Rolly Massimino. It's a youth movement at Villanova. Let's see how they respond tonight. Syracuse, fourth in the country and climbing at this time.
Man a man.
Thompson's out on Woodard. Edwards is going to pick up Walker. Coleman jumps out on Dowdell. Lance Miller, who's played well for this club, number 14 in the white uniform. Chris Walker inside. Bird, and a jump hook for two.
Oh, and believe it or not, Rolly says Mr. Bird can dunk like Jordan.
Hamilton, right?
Well, I don't think he could play in President Carter's cabinet, but he can certainly get up there.
Syracuse setting the offense the first time. Coleman pops out, buries the J.
Well, he's known as Mr. Inside. He can stroke it outside, too. Villanova playing a lot more man-to-man, but you'll see a mixed bag of defenses by Rolly Massimino.
Just not too much on a basketball court, but Derek Coleman can't do.
Coach, maybe. A couple of years will change that.
He'd tell you he can do that. Woodard down at the baseline, bringing it back out. Looking down low again at Bird.
Michael, lost in their excellence offensively is their outstanding defense.
Dowdell lost it on the way up. Got it back with some good hands. Lance Miller coming right at him. Rebound controlled by Billy Owens out of the pack himself. Behind the back at half court. Owens.
Oh,
what a pass to Ellis, who finishes it off.
What a sequence. The reason they're better. A lot of guys can handle it in the open floor. Who better than Owens? On the money. What a great look. Floor too, huh?
That was a heck of a layup by Lamarcus.
Oh. Up and down.
Dowdell taking it in. Caught by Owens. No goaltend. The ball was short, even though Villanova bench gets up. Had no chance. Owens for two.
Pretty darn good. An awesome display early. That had no chance of going in. You're right, Michael. It was a good non-call by the officials. But in the open floor, not too many clubs better. You can't let them get the puppies up and down.
Great officiating crew here tonight. Tim Higgins, John Carpenter, Larry Lembo. Woodard wants it. Can't knock down the jumper. Miller kept it alive. Dowdell. Rebound. Owens stripped and reach in foul on Dowdell.
Got to make those early ones. Finish inside. The great thing about the Syracuse defense, and it's more of a setup defense than, say, Georgetown, is that they'll deny deep on the floor, and yet they really go after inside shots. A very aggressive team.
6-2 Syracuse lead. Jim Boeheim. His club got off to a big early lead against Connecticut, then held on Saturday night.
A little different look now. A little zone. Trying to get organized. Now they're back. The man to man.
Tim Higgins foul off the ball. Could be LeVon Ellis. It is Ellis. His first on the team.
Really not necessary, right? An empty trip there is.
He's getting the message right now, is it?
He's getting so personable. I've dubbed him Don Rickles, Mr. Warmth, you know. But very enjoyable to chat with. Because the way they're playing, why not? As Ellis gets another one, huh?
Yep. Two quick ones as he reached in on Bird as he went by. Bird with that quick first step.
His defense inside, Mike, excuse me, is excellent. Terrific post defender.
Rolly Massimino would dearly love the upset here tonight. Had the smile on before the game. Really seems in good spirits coming in.
Now they always play Syracuse well, or so it seems. And one of those guys that plays so well is Tom Grice, and I'm sure we'll see him because of his offensive ability in low. Jimmy Boeheim says they're going to have to bump him out when he comes in, get him away from that little jump hook or turnaround jumper.
One of two for Bird. Ellis clears. Edwards in the middle.
Here's the zone again, Mike, and they've been switching back to the man-to-man.
Owens off the wing, knocks down the three.
A different Billy Owens, huh? Well, from earlier.
His confidence level is through the roof of this place.
Of course, next year it's his show with Derek on and Stevie as well.
Cut. Thompson got a hand on it, knocking it out of bounds. Larry Lembo, though, thought he was a little too aggressive.
What Stevie did there is he got caught behind and tried to recover. He didn't lead Woodard across the lane.
Third foul on Syracuse, first on Thompson. Lance Miller set to inbound.
Mike, 2-3 against the zone, and it very effective. They played the pass in the corner.
Freshman didn't see an opening. He called a timeout. Just under 17 to go, first half. The Cuse by 9.
Little ability overall to handle the ball in the open floor.
This is just gorgeous. 6'9" delivery, folks. And the finish by a 6'10" guy. And, of course, Edwards is well running the break for them. They're just really tough to defend. Of course, Billy Tubbs, who I really enjoy, and shakes it up, says, they're a Big East basketball, puts you to sleep. Well, Billy, I hope you watch that couple of sequences.
And the foul is going to go against Woodard, who lowered his shoulder into Michael Edwards. Second team foul as Rowley kind of buries his face in his hands. And
pretty much under control, Rowley, as you see the great defense. Jimmy says they've been rated 1 or 2 in the league for most of the years of the Big East in field goal percentage, but they're not thought of as a great defensive team.
Edwards trying to loosen things up with a three that doesn't go down. Walker, the quick push. Walker, a real key for this club. He has had some big games for Villanova this year. Tom Grice into the lineup first time, number 33, making his way to the paint.
Let's see if they can keep him away from the basketball and bump him out.
Woodard. takes it strong and gets two.
Well, if he can start using the bounce, he can open up his game. No question he can stroke the ball from the outside.
Syracuse by four now. Oh, he's very comfortable out on the wing when they have to go to the half-court offense.
Well, they're backing in a man-to-man, a sloughing man-to-man.
Coleman. Gets it, right? Just powered it up over Grice.
There's the inside. You saw the stroke deep earlier.
Second bucket for Derek tonight. Syracuse by six.
Chris Ellis with the two fouls. Wouldn't be bad for Grice to touch it, try and get him number three.
Woodard again putting it on the floor. No foul on the drive, says Larry Lembo. Nice looking basket.
Sure
you
was.
Play at another level, you get a three-point play out of that, Chris.
Yeah, that's a house call. An NBA three, no question, Mike. Once you pick it up and start. And they gave the bump earlier, huh? They give that to Ellis?
Yes, they did. That's three.
Then it should have been a good goal.
Richard Manning now on the floor. In the middle, taking Ellis's place. Walker will reset the offense with a fresh 45.
Mike, against the 2-3 now, you might see some wing or top-of-the-key jumpers. Not a good defense against Villanova.
With Woodard, right where you said. Rebound Coleman. Quick outlet to Owens. In the middle, Edwards. Back to Billy on a wing. Battle for the board, and they got Richard Manning on a reach-in foul. So the foul's piling up a bit here on Syracuse early.
Michael, that's the break, though. You see Edwards with a give-back, an open jumper. He gives it up early enough so that the good players can develop something.
5 fouls in less than 5 minutes on Syracuse.
Straight up man again.
The big Rodney guy. Taylor in the game first time, too.
Big guy trying to go box to box. Good for him to reverse the ball if he doesn't have something for himself.
Miller looked inside at Grice, leaves it for Woodard. Outside jumper won't go. Another rebound for Coleman's got some help on the break. Alley-oopo leaves it for Thompson.
Oh! Is that gorgeous? I mean, the snatch and then the layoff. Catchable. Billy can be at another level, can he?
Yes, he can. Yes, he can.
How would you like to be a point guard? Just throw it up there. Somebody's going to go get it for you. You never look bad.
Grice touching it first time. Little turnaround is short. Tap won't go. Grice keeps it alive to Taylor. And Walker will reset. Fresh clock.
Tommy up big for him.
Miller has it slapped away by Owens. Just playing the whole game, isn't he? Rodney Taylor saw that pass coming.
Long bounce pass. Villanova at some point is going to have to get some easy baskets, though, Mike.
Walker squares up. Oh. Nice rebound. Taylor over the top. Tries to power it back up and does.
Well, he's come in and established himself, hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
Big, strong kid. Of course, he and Tom Grice have not really meshed well with the quicker, younger kids. They've always been pulling and tugging at one another.
Thompson takes it down the lane. Oh, Stevie got some moves.
And he had a layoff as well. You can't let dribble penetration occur that easily. You have to set up and make the man turn.
Syracuse by eight. What the pace of this one?
Again, Villanova not wanting to run, but I think they're going to have to get some opportunity breaks.
Grice leaning and leaning.
Look at this. Gets the tip. Great second effort. I mean, he's just tough for some reason against Syracuse. He can't put it into play against the other guys in the league.
Manning down in the corner thought about it. Stevie Thompson will let it fly. Rebound to Woodard. Walker looking up the floor, finds Lance Miller, cuts in, offensive foul. Ooh. Guess who got there?
Your man, Billy, reading beautifully. Great effort. I'm not so sure he got there in time, Mike, but it was a terrific effort. And really almost resigned now to see what kind of team for him shows up before he lets the shirt out and the tie loosen.
Aaron Bain has checked in for the Villanova Wildcats first time tonight, another of the fine freshmen on this club. So it's Walker, Woodard, Bain, Taylor, and Grice on the floor. Only change for Syracuse, Richard Manning for LeRon Ellis, who got three quick fouls. Coleman finds Thompson. Manning will try. Richard Manning, 6'10", sophomore with his first two.
Jimmy does have some more answers, though, doesn't he, up front?
A ton of answers on that front line.
He's got nine, and, you know, you think of McCray, Hopkins, Johnson, Scott.
Walker, nice quick move. Got Edwards in the air. Short with the jumper. Villanova, one would think, needs a big game out of Chris Walker.
And quick shot that time, maybe. He has been a steady influence for this team, though.
Owens finds Coleman on a cut. And two different officials had him on the wall.
Nice cut. And, of course, Tom Grice in a disadvantaged position. But if they can get it to Coleman that easily, they're in trouble.
17-9, Syracuse.
Sometimes.
Jam with color and excitement. Check out the sparkling sights.
Season, it looked like it might be a long one for Syracuse, but it got turned around when Michael Edwards came into the starting lineup and they shot the ball better.
Well, the main thing is we shot the ball better, and some of that's because of Mike Edwards, but I think some of it's just we had a couple game shooting slump at the beginning of the year, and now we're shooting the ball well, and I think that's the real key difference.
Jim Boeheim's thoughts on the turnaround. They are certainly shooting the ball better tonight. 8 of 11 from the floor, and it gives them an 8-point lead.
That stubborn streak, huh? I know he's not Irish, but he's not going to concede.
Aaron Bain, nice move, won't go down off the glass. And Richard Manning, a tough rebound quickly to Edwards. Owens the trailer.
Bain does some great things going to the hole, doesn't he?
Yeah, Bain's a good-looking young player, number 44 for Villanova.
So when they get the ball to the high spot, they dump down beautifully.
Owens, tough shot. Rebound loose out of bounds, and Syracuse will keep it as Thompson was up there with Bain, Walker, and Woodard. Dave Johnson will check into the game for the first time, and Steve Thompson will sit down.
Well, this flexibility lets Jim Boeheim rest guys, too. They don't have that long period where they're exhausted. They can still guard, because that's where you lay back a little bit.
Calvin Bird back in, and Woodard out.
Tough match for Dowdell right now. Here they switch. And it's Rodney Taylor on Derek.
Edwards trying to penetrate. Dave Johnson really got up there on the jump, but couldn't get the shot down. Manning, good scrap to keep it alive out of bounds. And it's John Clockett, he's got it the other way.
Pretty good coordination. Now, Timmy Higgins didn't see it. Right, Clockett called. They do attack the glass, though. A lot of big guys, very active and quick to the basketball.
Chance for the Wildcats to get to six. Just about halfway through this first half. First game of a triple header here on Big Monday. Calvin Bird to the hole. Oh. Manning was there for the block.
What a reaction, Michael, all the way from the box. Not a great offensive team on the floor for Villanova. They need some penetration or some low post play. But right here, good recovery and helping his teammate.
Bain gets it into Bird. Right back to Bain along the baseline.
Yeah. Enough room, huh?
Nope, Richard Manning got him on the way by.
Oh, is that one of those? That's that force, or that's why you like the force, right? The little nickel dimer. And a smile creases the face of the mentor. You better see a good bang. You're going to get one.
Well, Manning picked up his second foul. So Ellis and Manning have picked up five fouls between the two. Bird to Walker. Well, Calvin's just looking to slash to the hole, isn't he, when he gets his hands on the ball?
Not a good delivery, though.
Owens the other way. A little shake and bake on Walker. Got stripped, picked off by Johnson on the baseline. Kick it out to Edwards.
Quick to the ball. That was up for grabs.
And Bird jumping in, and they got Bird with the foul. Edwards kind of lost the dribble.
You're right, Mike. He just got his body in on it. I tell you, Calvin Bird does go to the hole, though. I mean, he's a confident kid. May have shattered a little bit of the glass on that jumper, so the shot selection has to improve.
Right, let's watch here and note 10-10 to go, first half, 17-9. Edwards has gone to the bench, so Thompson will go back to his point guard job. And Grice got Coleman with the push.
Michael, there's the high-low. Even though Manning was 3 feet on top of the circle, Derek Coleman had sealed underneath and presented for the ball. Tom Grice was at a disadvantaged position.
right, doesn't he? Coleman's turnaround is long. And Bain, good position rebound.
A lot of empty trips for both clubs, really. They asked me about tempo. Syracuse with a few breaks, but basically half-court offense.
Bain, a little drive baseline. He got hit by David Johnson, and he'll go to the free throw line. First foul on Dave. And we're at the Spectrum here in Philadelphia. First of three tonight on Big Monday. 9:39 to go first half. 17-9, the fourth-ranked Orange Men of Syracuse, leading the Villanova Wildcats. The Wildcats, though, have won the last two games in this building and handed Syracuse their worst loss ever in the Carrier Dome just about a month ago.
Of course, they got to make the easy ones. They've had a couple of layups, a couple of free throws missed.
The numbers for Aaron Bain, first time around. Aaron Bain, who played last year on the same high school team with George Lynch, the fine freshman of North Carolina. It's not a bad front line, huh?
Not at all. And he's been up and down. He was good early, struggled. Now he looks a little bit better, more confident. Man to man.
Price on Coleman. Coleman wants to take him. Lost it on the way up. Just lost the handle, and it's picked off by Bain.
I think he was so excited at the sight.
Villanova a chance to get to five in a low-scoring affair.
Well, Manny let Grice block him down. He's tough when he's down low.
Bird needs a little help. Look at Owen. Second time he's picked a pocket, and Bird gets him with the foul. Jim Boeheim was up wanting Billy to avoid the behind the back and get the ball ahead because he had some guys. Yeah.
It was one of the few mistakes he'll make. And there's a man that wins 25 a year, and the smile comes on maybe after he makes a birdie on the 18th to beat somebody. That's why they win. He drives them pretty good.
Bain goes to the bench, Woodard back in.
Can't give the ball up that easily. Bird's done it twice. A little bit of the zone now.
Thompson looking to slash. A little pull-up jumper short. Grice is there. Walker finds Lance Miller to Grice. Putting it on the floor. Running hook shot.
That slid down to the palm on Tommy, yeah. But I think you can run on Syracuse. But what they do is they put so many guys on the glass, you can look and get that easy break.
5-point game.
Well, inside switching on the exchanges.
Good look down low, and Owens will go to the free throw line.
Dowdell got caught on the switch, grabbing.
Second foul on Mark Dowdell. Villanova over the limit. It was a shooting foul anyway, so Billy Owens will be at the free throw line.
Well, you were at the Connecticut game Saturday, and talking to Jimmy Boeheim, he said, we played real well. He said, and I told everybody when Connecticut beat us how good they were. And, of course, up in his area, there are a few non-believers.
They tend not to listen.
When Syracuse loses, because they win so often, but the UConn would have just an outstanding season. And Jimmy Calhoun, they're going to be awfully tough in the NCAA.
It's a very, very good basketball team.
Well, people will be unfamiliar with the style, which will be conducive to their success. Of course, the inexperience.
Best basketball team I have ever seen that every night shoots 40%.
They struggle, huh?
They do, but they win.
Well, they get you to turn it over, take quick shots. And playing together, too.
Owens missing the second. 18-12, 6-point game.
Tommy, one of those tippy-toe rebounds there.
And it's Miller on a wing to Grice. He'll do that same run and hook again.
There's the kick he's pretty good at. Looking opposite.
Plenty of time, still 30 on the shot clock. And the shot clock is something Villanova would like to use.
A little picks for Walker.
Edwards did a good job staying with him.
Stevie really shadows a guy, doesn't he?
Yep.
Nice. Plays him great.
Miller lost it. Owens tipped it, and Dowdell, the quick hands, finds Woodard. He's got time. Grice the follow.
And a heady play by Tom. Caught it and put it back up. They've had it blocked to begin down and set.
Grice with six, Syracuse by four, and the 17,000 back in it here at the Spectrum.
Really been mostly man-to-man by Villanova. A little switching.
Syracuse hasn't scored a basket in a week, it seems like. Thompson there for an offensive board. Can't get it up on the other side. Coleman, those great hands of his. And he will go to the line as he got hit by Dowdell or Walker. Take your pick.
I think he got Walker, Mike. He does have a way of tipping to himself, controlling the ball. And obviously when it's all alone, can go get it with the best of them.
Here comes Conrad McCray getting some early minutes as Richard Manning sits down. Again, Jim Boeheim having to go three deep now at that center position. McCray, a big freshman out of New York City, as Derek Coleman will break Sherman Douglas's record before the year is through. It would appear Sherman stay at the top of the Syracuse point list, a short one.
Yeah. Coach Sherman playing very well with the Miami Heat. And look at these numbers, 12.6, fifth in the nation. Here's a guy that's played a lot more forward away from the basket but can still dominate with the best of them. Well, Conrad getting about 10 minutes a game, so this is good for him. Comes tournament time.
Coleman's got a half dozen, and that's the Syracuse lead. We'll be back.
Get ready for a special Sports Illustrated sneak preview.
It's unreal. The man, it's like he's from another planet.
You never know what he's going to do.
He doesn't even know. He just does it, and you're like, duh.
They just saw an amazing video cassette presented by Sports Illustrated, starring the most exciting figure in sports today.
Who else? Jordan.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, he's unbelievable.
Michael Jordan, Come Fly With Me 1990. Over 40 minutes of the game's ultimate playmaker. Yours free with your paid subscription to SI.
Yes!
Call toll-free and get 26 issues of SI at over 45% off the cover price.
I didn't realize you could save that much.
Including SI's blockbuster baseball preview, the giant 35th anniversary covers issue, and the red hot swimsuit issue.
So what's the catch?
No catch. You get it all for just three monthly installments of $12.97 each. Even use your credit card.
Golden. Let's do it.
Save over 45% and get the Jordan video free.
You're going to be giving away a lot of these babies starting right here.
One of the better players in the country will be along at 9:30 for Michigan State. And then late tonight, midnight, the third game, Long Beach State. Still a team that could be in the NCAAs against UNC Charlotte.
Now, Michael, I used to have a priest that prayed for me. Now, Rowley's got to tell him, this is Father George Riley, who's their vice president in charge of development. And he spoke at a dinner for Bob Mulcave, the Meadowlands, and said he was going to root them home this evening. He's going to need some help. He can't stop that fast break with prayers, I don't think.
Syracuse got to start putting the ball back in the basket, though, after a quick start. Their shooting percentage has really fallen off. David Miller in the game for his time at the point for Villanova.
Still man-to-man, straight up. Coach McCray, a little more inexperienced play, huh?
Oh, a hustle play there goes for naught.
And maybe number one down on the Pines. Any of you young guys out there watching the game? You got to do it all. Here's the 2-3 again, Mike, and occasionally you'll get a nice open jumper if you're patient against it. Much stronger man-to-man team.
Wooded, Taylor, Grice, Bain, and Miller.
Those numbers.
Down low, Rodney Taylor, and he got fouled. Not sure who the reach-in was on. Let's see.
I think Edwards may have gotten down there. He's got to reach up pretty high. Boy, what a confident kid he is, too, Michael, since he was inserted. And you read the remarks about him being picked after Kenny Anderson. You know, Kenny made his decision, and then he said, hey, Kenny Anderson's a great player. Didn't bother me at all. I mean, that's the ability and yet confidence, too, to come in and perform, relax, and then get in and do the job.
No sin. Someone says you're just not quite as good as Kenny Anderson.
No.
No sin there.
There's a lot of guys in that league.
Four points for Rodney Taylor now off the bench, and Villanova hanging around, down four with 6.5 to play first half.
It's really been straight up, man. As I mentioned, the occasional switch inside. I just think Derek could do some damage on the box against Rodney Taylor or Grice.
Edwards trying to reset. Owens is down there trying to post up Bain. They find Billy, tipped away nicely by Bain, but he tracks it down. Oh, and right through the hands of Steve Thompson out of bounds.
Didn't catch it first. Was looking to make the move.
Villanova a chance to get to two as Rowley calls the play.
Well, you can gauge them by him. Now he's up. Of course, you know, you try and get into a game with Syracuse by not getting blown out early. Get a little comfort zone, particularly with your offense.
pass, something of an adventure, but tracked down by Taylor. Bain now will fire. Caught by Woodard underneath. Woodard will take a try. Taylor an offensive board. Syracuse standing around a bit. Billy Owens the reach-in foul.
Well, Jimmy was saying that before the game, they guard so far out on the floor, they don't get back and rebound on occasion. They give up those offensive rebounds. You can see that happening right now.
Chris Walker's going to come back in. Dave Miller goes to the bench. Dave, the brother of Lance Miller. Dave, a sophomore. Lance, a freshman on this Villanova squad. And Rodney Taylor, 6'6 senior, has had an injury-filled career at Villanova, but shows up to play all the time.
Bandage, but ready to play.
Yep.
AC Florida, the X-Man, Xavier McDaniels, all high school. Tyrone Corbin, another one out of there.
Thompson high for the missed free throw.
If Syracuse shows a little patience, I think they can get whatever they want, Mike. The collapsing defense has been giving them some problems.
Thompson down on the baseline, spinning, short, goes and gets it. Long that time, and Aaron Bain, a tough traffic rebound. Bain bringing up himself with a left-handed dribble. Owens trying to swallow him up. Bryce wheeling in, and he'll go to the free throw line on the hook.
He wanted it, didn't he?
He took it.
Defensively, McRae really got him out far, forcing Tom, and you could see the defense didn't get down and help. Anytime that big guy puts it down, you've got to go strip him.
Yeah, that foul of Derek Coleman is first.
Eye on Tom Grice. I said, how'd you get that? Walk into something? He said, no, the heat of battle. He said, Bobby Martin. Because this has hurt them. A lot of single trips. I mean, does he show his emotions? Right on the sleeve. Because he was like that at Hillside High School, Mike. So it's no different.
Missed them both. Interesting. Watch Grice now on the other end. He's had a tendency, something like that can bother him if he misses a couple of free throws. Let's see what he does on the defensive end.
Now they really collapse it. Coleman being forced to come out a little bit.
Thompson wants to go into Coleman. Now he goes to the other side.
Nice.
Here's Coleman on the blocks, and Walker got there late. No, they got Grice with a push.
Nice reversal, though. You mentioned Derek Coleman released for the other box. A lot of clubs would well stay on one. They reversed it and got him on the other side. They're looking for the big guy.
Second personal on Grice. Coleman to the free throw line. Derek has six. 4:44 to go in the first half at Syracuse with just 20 points.
I asked him if he called Dave Bing, his buddy, who's gone into the Hall of Fame, which he certainly deserves. And he said he called but didn't get him. He had left for Miami. And a great honor for Dave and for Syracuse University and the Pistons. But he's had a great influence on Derek's life. And I mentioned that last time we had Syracuse with Seton Hall. I think he's matured because of that relationship as well as Jimmy's influence.
Strong rebound and put back down low. That's the first basket in almost 8 minutes for Syracuse. Woodard inside. Grice double team. Wants it anyway. Rebound McCray.
See him clear out too, and that's a job going to Miss Taylor.
Syracuse showing a little more patience the last couple of trips as you call
for. Look at
this. There's Thompson free for two.
And he may have gotten hit on the top of the head, too.
Does that as well as anyone when he gets that baseline pass, uses the basket.
Can he reach across? He's got a long arm span, but so heady, too. See how he denies Woodard? I mean, he's a great defender.
Got him with the leg that time. Second foul on Steve Thompson.
You know, when you look at Stevie and talk to pro scouts, a lot of them say, well, he can't do this, he can't do that, but he is a winner. And Jimmy Boeheim was saying before the game, he's the kind of guy that the pros talk about, and then they won't draft him.
Yeah,
so he's a little bit upset at it. Because the only weakness, that chink in the arm, are the free throws.
You would never stop complaining. You'd be talking for a week about
it. Woodard has no weakness at the free throw line. 90% free throw shooter, and had 16 of those 27 points from the line in that first game against Syracuse.
He should spend the whole summer having his buddies run at him and make him put it on the floor, either hand, because he can stroke it and open up that other facet of his game.
Woodard gets them both. It's a six-point game, 25-19, with 3:45 to go first half.
Coleman looks at the man as he goes away, but then regains eye contact, able to deflect. And now this is just incredible. I mean, offering up the body to come up with the loose one, and then just not good offense by Bird, but Billy Owens able to deflect and then look up the floor with that offense in mind. Two terrific performers.
If you don't play good D, you can't win. Says Jim Boeheim, the offense comes from the defense. Tonight, the offense has not been there, but the defense has been true. 19 points given up in 18 minutes.
The last month, huh?
Yes.
Right on the money.
Thompson thought about the three. Edwards nearly traveled down there as he slid into the corner.
Good seal there. You saw Woodard help out.
14 on the shot clock. That was travel.
Yep. Rolled to a stop. And that was impatience, immaturity maybe. And yet he's going to be one wise guard when it's all over.
Syracuse at 48% shooting. Make it 50. 48, there we go. And 26 for Villanova, and they turn it over.
A skitter. That's one of those ones you can't get your hands down fast enough. And they really didn't have to be in any hurry. That was an important set for Villanova.
Except for a couple of trips here in this first half, Bill. This is as quiet as 17,000 are going to be in a building at one time.
Well, the pace, I would say, is Villanova's right now. Huh? Low numbers.
Owens, a double pump job, gets his own rebound. Good strip by Walker. Woodard. And credit Syracuse getting back. That looked like a chance for one of those opportunity baskets. Rodney Taylor knocks it down and gets fouled.
Pretty good balance, you're right. But the gambling then, as they reset, Mike, yep. You've got to be patient defensively, too. You don't want to deny and gamble and set up open jumpers. McCray out big, though. Terrific reaction as he gets tagged with one.
Big first half for Taylor. He's got 8 points, averages only five a game. And now the building comes alive again as the lead's down to three.
A little switch defensively, too. Back into a 2-3. It was a 1-1-3. Test the outside shooting.
Thompson slashes in the paint. Little jump. Hope goes down, and he gets a foul.
Michael, for some teams, you test the outside shooting. Syracuse, you would think big. McCray or Coleman. No, the 6-3-4-5. Small forward, big guard, with a nice-looking kiss. That was banged home.
Manning back in. And Conrad McCray goes to the Syracuse bench. Steve Thompson. That's a good question. Can he make it in the NBA? We discussed it a little bit earlier there, Bill.
Uh-huh.
You think he can?
Well, I think there's a spot for him, but he's got to improve in a lot of areas, specifically the outside shooting. And of course, the free throws would help too, but he's got the heart for it, Mike.
Miller. Nice drive, won't go, and Thompson up big for the rebound. You get an open game like this, he can play with anybody.
Well, the quick shot sort of helps Syracuse. You got to make them.
Derek Coleman squares up. Oh, tapped in by Thompson.
My, what a slasher. I mean, he just sees things and finds holes. Just so aggressive in nature.
He's in double figures here tonight with 10. Thompson, Owens, and Coleman have accounted for 25 of the 29 on the board for Syracuse. Dowdell wants to go strong. Stripped by Owens, picked off Thompson. Here's Edwards looking to run. Billy Owens with some room, leans in, won't go on the kiss. Dowdell the rebound.
There's that dribble by Edwards, pushed the defense back. They didn't notice Billy Owens.
Walker back. Now he'll reset. We approach 1 minute to play first half. Lance Miller tees it up. Rebound to Edwards. He's got Owens on a wing. Thompson as a trailer. Edwards looking for Thompson. It's tipped away and out of bounds. It'll be Syracuse ball. Don't forget, stay with us at halftime. John Saunders will be by. Scores and the new top 25. A report on all those problems out at Drake and a preview of the second third of Big Monday, Michigan State and Iowa.
Jim Boeheim waving out, wants one. Take a couple of the missed layup and then the steal. Because Villanova, I just think, has got the game in the numbers they would like. Just a matter of the type of shot they're going to get at the other end of the second half.
14 now on the shot clock, so Villanova's going to get at least 10 seconds to put a shot up. Five on the shot clock. Owens, good lead. Rims it though. Manning can't get it. Walker off to the racers. Edwards, breakaway foul. Well, the guy's just going to count the basket. Edwards took a couple of swipes at him from behind.
I know. Rowley's begging for it, and you can't blame him, but that's that open floor speed. The easy basket you need against one of the nation's best clubs.
Now watch Edwards on the way down.
He's trying to get him. Oh, on the head.
Yeah, twice.
Timmy waited for that one, but tell you, they just need the explosion, Mike. They can't just play half court all the time. Two pretty quick guys running after one another.
You got that right. That's what Villanova needs tonight, is to walk the heat it up with the three-point plays. There's the old-fashioned one there. Makes it 29-25, 6 seconds to go. James Bryson comes in defensively for this last trip.
Villanova trying to rag a little bit to see if they can make it a tougher 6 seconds.
Edwards comes up shooting. Catches some rim. Owens. Ooh, that would have counted, but it didn't go.
Ever alert.
It's a Villanova pace and a Villanova score. They're not ahead, but they're in it. 29-25 Syracuse at halftime. Let's go back to John Saunders. John?
Mike and Bill, as you say, a four-point game, 29-25, very low scoring. The Orangemen don't like to see that. You'll recall they've already lost to Villanova once this year up at the Dome. Let's check the scoreboard. Number six, Duke. They dropped in the rankings after losing in the ACC this week, and they're down by one to Stetson and the Hatters. It's 26-25 in the first half. LaSalle's number 14. They're down to St. Joseph's of Pennsylvania. 56-49 is that score in the second half. Kentucky and Florida in the SEC. The Gators trying to pull this one off at home and end a seven-game losing streak. Is 44-36 at halftime. Virginia Tech and Richmond, and the Spiders have an eight-point lead as they went to the locker rooms. James Madison, East Carolina, four-point game. Madison and the Dukes with the lead there. In the Sun Belt, Jacksonville up big over Virginia Commonwealth, 39-19 at halftime, a 20-point lead. George Mason down to ODU. It's 45-32 in the first half, and DePaul has the lead in the Battle of Independence over the Hurricanes of Miami. It's 26-16. Stay with us. When we come back, we will preview our game in the Big Ten, that one Iowa and Michigan State. But first, as we continue on Big Monday, here's a look at the new top 25. One and two are the same, but they have switched positions. Missouri now number two and Kansas number one. They'll meet here on ESPN tomorrow night.
Penalty against Bud Light. What was the call? Too much glue on the label, a 12-pack on the field, or illegal use of hands? Nothing beats it.
Illegal use of hands! Chris, what happened?
If that was your call, this Bud's for you.
Syracuse versus Villanova is brought to you by Budweiser. Beechwood age for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. By Payne Weber, serving the financial needs of individual, corporate, and institutional clients. And by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Syracuse leading Villanova by four that game in the Big East. In the Big Ten, it will be Michigan State and Iowa. Michigan State having to go on the road. Let's go to Iowa City now and join Mike Patrick at Carver Hawkeye Arena. Mike.
Oh, thank you, John. And you're looking at Carver Hawkeye, the home of Iowa basketball, where the Hawkeyes have won 80% of their games since 1983. Purdue's loss to Minnesota yesterday tightened up the Big Ten race again. The Boilermakers just one game ahead of Michigan and Michigan State. They're only two up on the Golden Gophers. Good evening, everybody. Mike Patrick along with Dick Vitale, and we'll be back with Big Monday Part 2 in about an hour. When you look at those standings, the amazing thing is that Purdue and Michigan State were written off before the season started.
Mike, unbelievable story. Judd Heathcote's got a fine basketball team. And I'll tell you one thing. After tonight, this is a big game for Michigan State, only one game behind Purdue. And then after tonight, their next three games are in their living room floor, their new field house. So today is a big game against Iowa.
Now, the last time Michigan State won the Big Ten race, they had a great player by the name of Magic Johnson. They're a contender again, and it's because they have another great guard.
Oh, no doubt about it. This kid is an absolute sensational player, multi-dimensional. He's one of the best-kept secrets in basketball, Steve Smith. Better than 18 points a game, 7 rebounds a game, and 5 assists. He can do it all, but the guy to watch tonight, he's the Upset City Special, Les Jepson, the 7-footer. He has made himself an NBA first-rounder, and the crowd here loves him. They're out here early. He's got great work ethic. Hey, remember Illinois, Michigan? They left with big L's here from Carver Hawkeye Arena.
Michigan State at Iowa coming up in about an hour. Part two of Big Monday. Right now, let's go back to John Saunders.
Thanks a lot, Mike Patrick, Dick Vitale. Iowa trying to pull off their third upset at home in the Big Ten this year. Stay with us when we come back. We'll take a look into the problems in Des Moines, Iowa at Drake University. It's a 4-point game at halftime.
Big players met today with University President Gene Smith
to discuss team problems. Smith says the problems involve coach Nelson Catalina. ASU has 5 straight winning seasons. They're 13-9 this year, but they have lost 7 of their last 10 games. Catalina was aware of the meeting, but no one has disclosed exactly what those problems are. Now, last week, a player boycott at Drake University forced coach Tom Abadamarco to be reassigned. The players alleged, among other things, abuse from Tom Abadamarco. But as Andrea Kramer tells us, there's simply more to come in this problem, and the story ends from where it began 2 years ago.
And I think that what you can do sometimes in any basketball program is sit around and complain about the negatives. I like the positives of Drake.
We have reassigned Coach Abadamarco to other duties in the athletic department.
How quickly things have changed for the coach whose team biography says is the perfect match for Drake basketball.
The players just didn't like some of the treatment they were getting off the court, you know.
Like what?
It wasn't, you know, wasn't like, it was like if we wanted to come up and just talk to our coach, we didn't feel we were able to talk to him.
I don't think not anybody heard something like, how you grades? Are you doing okay? Are you failing out of school? Or are you living, you know?
This is not a situation where I feel that I did anything to abuse my kids, mentally or physically. I really don't. I think I was a disciplinarian. I was tough on them, rah-rah guy. But I don't think I did anything to abuse my players. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart.
How much of a distraction has this whole situation been?
It's affected us a lot because whenever you lose somebody that you've been around so much for the last year and a half, 2 years, it's still a lost one, you know, and it bothers you.
The irony is that this 18-year coaching veteran who's built a reputation as a fine recruiter who has great rapport with his athletes is accused of, quote-unquote, inhumane treatment, disregard of his players' academic progress, and minor NCAA violations.
A lot of the allegations and stuff that you've heard about, I don't know anything about, and that's the honest truth.
I have absolutely no reason to doubt that when the facts are presented that Coach Abadamarco will not be involved in any NCAA violations or anything of that sort.
We felt that we needed to do something, and that was to appoint the Internal Review Committee. When President Ferrari did that, he did that for the sole purpose of getting to the bottom of this.
There's been controversy over the way Drake is publicly handling its internal affairs. And then when the players hired attorney Lawrence Marcucci to represent them, there were suspicions about the motives for the players banding together.
My appraisal is that the whole process has gotten into the hands of the wrong people. I don't think it's that Tom has control of it. I don't think the athletic director has control of it. I don't think the administration has control of it. I think that it's just been turned over to the players, and that the players are being manipulated by someone else.
I think that Tom might be caught in a crossfire between some people that were unhappy with the administration's dismissal of Gary Garner with a year on his contract. Terry Robinson, Sam Rourke, and Brian Brown were not happy with Gary Garner, and now they're not happy with Tom Abatamarco.
Well, Drake's Court of Dreams has really turned into a living nightmare, and some major questions still remain. Will Tom Abatamarco ever return here to his office as head basketball coach, and if not, has there been permanent damage done to his career? How are the student athletes paying for their attorney's fees? And what about these so-called outside influences? Have they really been manipulating the players? And what about the athletes themselves? Are they truly united? There have been some signs of dissatisfaction. In fact, we've learned that one Drake player has already contacted another university, possibly about transferring. But all these questions will remain unanswered until the committee has reached its conclusion. From Des Moines, I'm Andrea Kramer, ESPN.
It starts the moment you start the car. An experience that's distinctly Volkswagen.
It's basketball. Syracuse versus Villanova
is brought to you by Nike, who reminds you to just do it. And by Volkswagen. Say the word. Farfrichnugen. It's what makes a car a Volkswagen.
The Orange looking to take the lead in the win column in the Big East over Georgetown. This would be their ninth right now. Let's return to the Spectrum in Philadelphia to Mike Gorman and Bill Raftery. It's a four-point halftime game.
All right, John, thanks very much. 29-25, the numbers. Syracuse on top by four, and they, at least early, Bill, they got a chance to run the break and ran it pretty well.
They're so effective in that open floor and so enjoyable to watch, unless you're the opposition. But the one thing about them running the break is they all can handle the basketball. They're unselfish in the break. We mentioned Edwards' ability to push it up the floor. And, of course, the catch and touch. And Stevie's just sensational in that open floor. But Owens, what a great give-off.
Four guys touching on the fast break. That's what you're looking for. Shooting percentages really down, 39 and 28. And down the lower right there, 0 for 6. You would think if Villanova's going to win this game, they've got to bury a couple of threes.
You like the threes. I think so. And obviously shoot the ball better and don't have empty trips, Mike. I just don't think they can afford it. Whereas Syracuse, with their great rebounding and second efforts, can.
They set a Big East record a couple of weeks ago for threes. Front line for Syracuse, as usual, responding tonight. Owens with 8. Steve Thompson doing his job. He's chipped in with 10. And Derek Coleman doing a little bit of everything and picking up 7 points. He is just a complete player, but Thompson really has had himself a game here so far.
Well, within this replay, you're going to see the ability. Villanova could run the floor if they could rebound. They've got four people inside the foul line, three plus Derek, but Stevie quicker to the rebound, quicker to the ball, and of course that negates any opportunity to get the breakaway basket.
And he will be out to start the second half along with Edwards. Ellis back in the game. LaRon Ellis had to sit a long portion of that first half, picked up three early fouls. Derek Coleman, of course, on the floor, Billy Owens. And on the other side for the Villanova Wildcats, Rodney Taylor, who came up big in that first half, led Villanova with 8 points. He's out there with Dowdell, Walker, Lance Miller, Greg Woodard. We are underway. Second half. First game on a big Monday.
2-3.
Skip pass Owens. Tipped away Dowdell as he saw it coming and got in front of Ellis.
Of course, now with the 2-3, it's going to put a little stress on the outside shooting if Rowley stays with it. Mostly man-to-man first half.
Thompson a little room, finds Edwards. Owens down low, Ellis gets it back on a kickback. Billy for the three. Rebound, Coleman, an offensive board. Wants to go back up and does off the glass.
Got hit too, Mike. A lot of slaps and bumps. But that ability to weak side rebound, seal his man off. Terrific rebound.
Coleman's got 9, Syracuse by 6, just underway here, second half. Walker, good. Top of the key.
Good denial.
Dowdell has to come out for the ball. Woodard nowhere to go. Now he finds Taylor. Open jump shot.
Well, they punish the help of Owens with a good look and step into that foul area by Taylor. Yes. Your guy tonight,
huh? 6'6 senior, double figures with 10. Villanova hanging around, and that's pretty much what Rolly wants him to do, just hang around until maybe 5 minutes to go. This crowd has not been a factor, and the Spectrum's really pretty close to full. Thompson can't get the turnaround down, and Calvin Bird, or Lance Miller, rather, unable to save it down on the baseline.
Well, you can see Stevie Thompson's got to push the defense in with the dribble. They're not confident setting up and shooting the open jumper. Back to man-to-man.
Thompson was trying to post up Miller there for a moment. Then he got out of the way. They go into Coleman. Nice catch. He's doubled immediately. Owens, little pull-up jumper. Really having trouble finding the range. And again, Lance Miller unable to handle it on the baseline. The Villanova bench wanted a bump called on Thompson. They won't get it.
I've been watching Billy Owens out of half court. He's shaking his head a little because of the in and out. You can't think that way if you're a scorer. You've got to just be confident. It's the ball's fault or the rim's fault, not yours. As Woodard tags Mr. Coleman.
Second foul on Greg Woodard. It's been a long trip for Jim Boeheim's club.
Too many second chances against this dynamic club.
It's like a half-court game. Edwards coming up with the loose ball. Ellis, who has shown some range, comes up firing. That was a little wild, and Rodney Taylor is there.
Big lead.
The Wildcats a chance to get to two. The 17,000 suddenly realize that.
Really a perimeter team right now. Not a lot of big guys on the floor for Villanova. You might see some inside-out play.
Woodard comes up firing. Hits the three.
One of the few times Stevie Thompson did not get out.
31-30. Wildcats to one.
Whereas the 2-3 slows your offense down in tempo. And, of course, puts the stress on the outside shooting.
Edwards got a screen from Ellis. Knocked away. Rodney Taylor got a hand in there. Thought it went off Owens, but Larry Lembo calls it Syracuse ball.
This is where Billy Owens can be effective outside. They're back to man-to-man.
Tipped away Lance Miller. Tracked down by Walker. Villanova's got some numbers here. Woodard.
Well, the old opportunity break, Mike. They need that. They have to take advantage and punish Syracuse.
Jim Boeheim calls a timeout. Wake-up call for about 17,000. Villanova by one.
Villanova's gone through it. They've fronted. They've helped that. Take a Derek Coleman out. And, of course, force a tough shot for Stevie, who may have gotten slapped as well. But when you let a team know you're going to run, they won't put as many people on the glass. And this particular fast break should loosen things up for Villanova, and they should be able to defensive rebound.
First lead of the night for Villanova comes with 17:09 to go in the game. Syracuse is just 5 of their last 25, and 1 of 5 shooting here second half.
Here's that 1-1-3 again, back to a 2-3. I think Billy Owens could do some damage at the top of the key to see over or shoot the basketball. And now they have him because he's down to throw.
How about finding Derek a few more times in the blocks?
Well, he finds holes, but this is what he's going to have to do, come out and do a little damage. Maybe that high-low where he pops to the foul line, Mike. He gets down below, he's going to get hidden.
There they find him down low. Turnaround, Woodard got there, but Derek got it back.
He's got to touch it more often, you're right.
Walker walking it up.
Syracuse man-to-man.
Woodard pops out, had a little room. Thompson goes by a second time.
Pretty good reaction.
Dowdell looking at finding. Miller can't get it down. Double tip. Rodney Taylor has had himself a heck of a basketball game here tonight. Foul on Coleman.
That he has. Of course, a big presence down underneath the basket. But you can see that Syracuse reaction to all the shots. I mean, they're just not relaxing out there.
Just a second on Coleman. No one in the game in any real foul trouble.
Go 2-3. Now, again, top of the key, wings, or the flash in the 3-second lane.
Lance Miller skips in the lane, finds Dowdell, blocked by Owen.
Oh.
Tim Higgins says, no, you got him on the arm.
Play on. Timothy. Pretty good reaction again. Of course, it's easy to whistle from over here, but you can see that area that's open, that 2-3. You can penetrate or hit the jumper, and I would say play on that one. Ooh! I used to say to officials, they don't understand how the big guys play at another level.
Rowley's club needs this second free throw to tie it at 33, 15:45 to go.
Much more subdued, though, huh? Almost tranquil on the play.
Edwards to direct traffic again. Jim Boeheim up and signaling.
So Billy's such a good passer. Owens over the top, Mike.
Push up!
Thompson tees it up. Back rims a three. Owens kept it alive. Oh, is that a big offensive
strong
rebound?
Pursuit.
Billy Owens now with 10. Thompson, Owens, and Coleman all in double figures, yet Syracuse only has 35 points. Woodard leaning. No call. Taylor, another offensive board. Back up. And they got Ellis with number 4.
And Dowdell, just terrific, keeping it alive. And the guy you've been after all night has been sensational. In the right spot, able to clean it up. And LeBron really hasn't been able to get untracked all night. The shirt is close to coming out, which means Villanova is back in the ballgame.
It's showtime. 35-33 Syracuse. Make it 35-34. 11 for Rodney Taylor off the bench.
Syracuse has to find a way to get Derek Coleman to touch the ball. Even against the zone, they've switched the look now. Let's see, man-to-man. I'd go right to him on Dowdell.
I was just going to say, man-to-man is right up their alley. They find
way.
Owens turnaround over Walker.
Either way, little mismatch at the guard spot. They start in a match, and then when the guy goes through, they've been playing man-to-man. Anything to throw you off, sort of a Philadelphia tradition.
Walker, ooh, trying to leave it in the lane. Dowdell, right spot. Look at Taylor again, and he'll go to the line one more time. Rodney Taylor's just beating him up inside.
Oh, this is what they wanted from Taylor when he came here. That ability to show strength, to be in position, to grab weak side rebounds, and of course take up some area. This is one of his better games that I've seen, Mike.
Tom Grice will make his way back into the lineup. Derek Coleman's going to go to the Syracuse bench. Dave Johnson comes in. Edwards goes out. Richard Manning has already checked in.
Derek will not be there for long. It's just a little blow. Let him relax. Remember years ago when Jimmy used to have Cycli on the sideline? It was...
Ronnie Cycli remembers those.
Ronnie looks back fondly at many memories, but that's not one of them, baby.
8 offensive rebounds for Rodney Taylor tonight. Syracuse by 1 in the ball.
Villanova does have a way of getting to the foul line, don't they?
Sure do. Manning's way.
There's a spot I like Owens out there.
Dave Johnson leaves it for Owens, throws up a 3 and hits one.
Penetration, the bounce, anything you can use to push the defense or make decisions, create decisions, can help your club.
15 now for Billy Owens on the night. Thompson out aggressively on Walker. Ellis has got Taylor.
Good
Manning's
cushion.
On Grice.
Good cushion, too.
Walker to the hole, leaves it. Miller, and Manning got him.
Pretty good reaction as Billy Owens got beat with a little peek. And Richie Manning, who earlier had a scintillating block, over to help again.
Calvin Byrd is going to check in, and Rodney Taylor goes to the Villanova bench.
He's putting the ball in the basket, but then he put the water in his mouth. Huh? Fortunately for Rowley.
Lance Miller, the freshman at the free throw line. First point of the night for Lance Miller, who came in 10-point-a-game scorer. He's had some big nights as a freshman. Two-point game. Walker picking up three-quarter court now.
Stevie's play a little point, gives Edwards a blow. First against man, Edwards, I think, is a little tougher.
Heard the near Steve. Oh, that pass was an adventure.
Well, the defense forced Manning out much further than he's used to, and now it's a little tougher for the big guy. Coleman just looked up at the clock like, Coach, I think it's time.
Rice comes high. Looks for a cutter. Miller Woodard on a wing. Dave Johnson quickly out on him. Again, Rice comes out to get the ball.
Johnson, pretty good defender, too. He's on Woodard.
Walker comes up shooting. Chris Walker having difficulty finding the range. Nice hands there. LaRon Ellis quickly to Owens. Owens on the break. Tried to go himself. Loose ball to Walker. Nova's got some numbers here again. Calvin Byrd couldn't control it.
Wrong decision, really. He had Woodard fanning out.
Yep.
And Byrd looks bad, but not a catchable pass by Chris Walker.
David Miller's going to come back in. Chris Walker will get a break on the bench with 12:34 to go in the game. Manning looking to Owens, who mismatch inside. Over Grace, but he sends it back.
Ooh. Tom in position.
Miller up to Grice, but he couldn't handle the pass.
And that a questionable decision there, too. You know, one thing that Villanova's done for years is control the basketball. They're not going to gamble on a break. Those are not good decisions. How about Grice, though? A swatter. The eraser.
Stevie Thompson has it sent back by Grice. Woodard, Ellis hustling back. Ellis has five.
Michael, forget Bill Russell. Villanova's got Tom Geis, the human eraser.
Never get off his feet on that one.
A tippy toe block, but in position twice, and it leads to a little excitement. Plus a deuce for Greg Woodard. Oh. Well, when you're in position, good things happen. This looks so much tougher.
His eyes look
with the bruised eye.
A little blacker, isn't it? Did he get popped again tonight?
I don't think he's ready to take on Mike Tyson.
Buster Douglas, maybe. Woodard makes the free throw. Nova back up by one.
Straight up, man.
Owens over the top. Coleman back in the game and gets immediately fouled. Calvin Byrd got him. Michael Edwards now over on the Syracuse bench getting a lengthy chat from Jim Boeheim. Rodney Taylor's going to come back in. We'll get a timeout first. 11:53 to go in the game. Nova by one. Nine years ago, Rolly Massimino's club met Syracuse for the Big East Championship, a game some call the best ever played in the Big East. Eric Santa for the steal, Eddie Moss to tip in to send it to overtime. In fact, it went three overtimes. Leo Routin's the final tap. Syracuse, their first championship. Jim Boeheim might find himself in overtime tonight the way we're going. 11:53 to go in the game. 41-40 Villanova by one.
Was Sean Kerins, Danny Shays in that shot?
Leo Routins, I saw him on a CBA game this afternoon on ESPN.
I think Leo can play in the next level. He just hasn't had the right shot. Straight up man.
Thompson, Johnson, Manning, Owens and Coleman. Manning looking inside, can't get it to Coleman. They do this time, lost it, and a little late for the reach-in call on Woodard.
Well, now that's the problem. Now, the one thing Grice is doing is he's chucking Coleman up a step. But what they have to do is run Coleman box to box, and Tom Grice is going to be playing catch-up. He can't rest and stay there. Then the advantage is Tom Grice.
Walker back in as David Miller goes to the bench. Dave Johnson on the wing.
Really collapsing defensively to help out.
Owens down low with a mismatch. Swatted away and picked off by Walker. Rodney Taylor got there. Woodard inside. Grice gets the handle, gets the shot. On the floor, says Larry Lembo. Somehow that rolled in.
Tough time controlling that. A little personality by Rich Manning. But Tom Grice is going to have to make quicker decisions once he gets hold of the basketball. But I think Villanova is a better team now when they push it down. And if there isn't anything, run something. Because now you've got Syracuse moving a little defensively. They're too tough when they're set up.
Villanova, good free throw shooting team, will be in the bonus for the rest of the night. 7 points now for Grice. Biggest lead of the night, too.
He comes up big against Syracuse, doesn't he?
He sure does. Coleman takes down the miss. Thompson and Edwards, the backcourt.
And once again, the 2-3.
And where do you want to go against
them? Well, the top of the key, and then they're switching to D now.
Edwards came up a little quick, strong underneath Owens. Back up, no. Grice a rebound. Outlet to Walker. He's got Woodard ahead. Walker takes it, finds Woodard. Got it.
Well, that's by design. Go find the hole. And Woodard went down and through.
Boy, they are alive in Philly right now. Edwards finds Thompson. Over Grice that time. I didn't know how he got it over.
Well, Bill Russell can relax now.
Somehow I don't think he felt too antsy anyway. Taylor top of the key.
Edwards is important in recognizing the defense, Mike, at the other end. And he's going to have to use the dribble a little bit more just to size it up.
Baseline.
Who was there? Derek Coleman. Great help.
Villanova ball though.
Chris Walker doesn't really need that. You know, he's got to bounce it. When it closes, bring it back out.
Aaron Bain will come in. Lance Miller goes out for the Wildcats. Roley keeps running them in and out. Walker. Fourth-ranked Syracuse Orange men are in trouble here. Follow Thompson twice, three times, but a foul on the second attempt. Walker picked it up.
Well, you know, he's so active. He's smart about the game. He takes advantage of his ability. He understands what has to be done, and he's quick to the ball besides.
Steve Thompson came up big at the Carrier Dome against Connecticut Saturday night at the free throw line. Made a lot of big free throws down the stretch.
Jimmy had the shot doctor, Ernie Hobby, up to look at Stevie Thompson, and he's really helped him. You mentioned against Connecticut.
Tip up won't go. Second tip won't. Taylor can't control it on the baseline.
How many of those have they had? And it's really the pursuit of Syracuse that's causing it.
Coleman will make the inbound pass. Over the top, Owens.
The old dummy play, right? Keep your hands down.
Coleman's turnaround. Over Grice for two.
Say goodnight. when he keeps moving box to box, flashing the lane, Tommy just can't get the puppies moving.
Syracuse coming with pressure. And there's a steal. Coleman!
Send it in, Derek!
And they're going to come right back with what works.
They saved it. Jimmy does not like to generally press Villanova or St. John's because they're patient.
Bean gets it back out. Walker. Not this time. Grice there. Got the ball.
Worked hard, got in position. Just a little laziness by Syracuse that time.
Villanova by two.
Man to man again.
Coleman had the shot. Now he'll take it. Rebound, Grice.
Well, Tom had the choice of going out or staying in. Chose correctly.
Walker calls the play. The entire Villanova bench, top of the screen, standing. Aaron Bean.
Syracuse standing up defensively right now. Not down, denying as much.
20 seconds on the shot clock. Walker with a high dribble, got away with it. Woodard trying to move on Thompson. And before the shot, Larry Limbo's got the foul, but Syracuse over the limit, so Villanova will be at the line.
Maybe Owens, if it is. That's the first little problem. That's number four, is it?
Yep, that's four on Owens. Ellis has five, Manning has four.
But if you're Jim Boeheim, though, the satisfaction of knowing that the press can get something for you if you turn it on.
You got to score to get into the press, though.
Yeah, you do. That's right. Of course, they're getting offensive opportunities on missed shots.
Woodard, a rare miss at the line, a 90% free throw shooter.
Straight up man.
Edwards finds Thompson. A little jump step of his. And the clock, yeah, that was going to count that if he went.
I think he's got Chris Walker with the reach in.
That's the third on Walker. We're going to get a timeout. 49-47. Nova, the surprising lead. Syracuse breaking hold on to this two-point lead. They've got Pitt, Temple, Georgetown, Boston College in the Big East tournament coming up. A win tonight be number 14, 18, everybody says, is that magic number.
Or 17 on occasion.
You got to hope for a lot of magic at 17, though.
Chris Rowley looking for anything he can get right now, particularly on the defensive rebound. I think Syracuse, just a little patience, they can get what they want, particularly with Derek, with Dowdell.
Here's the spin by Coleman, and he knocks down two more.
Here's the pressure now, Michael. We've got to get it, Walker. Look at this gamble.
Nice play, Ellis.
Tough pass.
And a bump on Walker.
They've got to get it to Walker's hands. You can't throw up those ducks, those quails. You see the foot speed as Ellis anticipated beautifully.
That's the sixth team foul, so the next one puts Villanova over the limit. Owens in the paint. And Lance Miller thought he had ball, but he got a bit of Billy. Just a second foul on Lance Miller, but Billy Owens will be at the free throw line. We're tied at 49 with 7:18 to go. First of three on a big Monday as Rolly Massimino looks on.
Always been in pain this year, has he?
He has.
Each game, like going to the dentist.
16 now for Billy Owens, 17 for Coleman, 13 for Thompson, and a total of 4 points out of everybody else on the Syracuse team.
Of course, now with the ability to make the free throw, they've got the pressure set up, and of course, Grice becomes important, too, in handling the ball. A little bit better in giving it to the right guy.
Owens doesn't get the roll, and there's Grice, who came back in for Taylor.
Of course, that takes away the pressure.
Yep. Woodard inside Grice. Kick it out, Walker.
See the chuck out by Ellis, trying to get Grice out a little bit further.
Ellis playing with five fouls. Walker, a little room in the baseline, leaves it for Grice. Wants to go. Coleman got a piece of it. Ellis got the ball. Villanova bench thought they had a foul. Edwards comes up fire. Still nobody else scored except the big three for Syracuse. Walker looking, finds Lance Miller on a wing. In, and that's it for LaRon Ellis as he got him with the body on the way by. So LaRon Ellis, the starting center, fouls out with 2 points.
Is that some confidence by Lance Miller attacking the big people? But down below, Tom Grice, when he took that shot, Derek, he had to come back to Derek's left hand. And of course, no way he's going to get away with it. That changes the inside defense.
It looks, from that little shot we had right there, like Jim Boeheim might be going to Dave Johnson here as opposed to Manning.
Of course, the size on the floor, he could put Coleman. It's pretty good matchups for him. You can have him play Tommy Grice.
Better pressing team, too.
Yep. Although Ellis came up with a great steal. Then he is the five-man, the back guy in the zone.
I was thinking more of the exchange for Manning. Lance Miller, 73% free throw shooter in Big East competition, 74 overall. Perfect tonight.
Well, Villanova's taking away the flow in the second half in terms of the running game. They haven't been able to get, the Orange men haven't been able to get running up and down, get the easy shots.
Villanova getting betrayed a little bit here at the line. Wood had missed the last trip. And we're tied at 50. Six and a half to go.
Now Dell with a tough match.
Owens just made a move without the ball.
And of course, again, the collapsing D.
Villanova, a chance for the lead.
Now Dell's liable to get something as they help out down below.
Miller, strong move. Tipped away by Dave Johnson. Owens, good hustle play.
Did not give up on it.
Everybody else did.
Pretty good communication, too, as Billy Owens went out of bounds. Derek let him know he was in position.
Derek letting Edwards know right there where he's going, I think, too.
And bring it down here, young man. Here's the high-low setup.
Coleman, couple of fakes, got Grice in the air, and they got the foul.
Now, the only problem I have with that call is it was made on the baseline. The good lean-in, you know, the NBA style of pump. Two officials outside, a better shot at making the call.
And Grice is third. Rodney Taylor is going to come back in, and he'll come in for Dowdell.
And one thing Grice does on offense, he's getting a little attention, particularly by Billy Owens. So if Taylor is his match now, remember Rodney's been making that foul line jumper, they're liable to find him.
We remain tied at 50.
They back it up, Mike. A little bit of a surprise. Maybe save the energy.
That is a surprise. Into Grice. Turns on Coleman. Spins the other way. Four fakes. Rebound, Taylor. Lance Miller keeps it alive on the other side.
But Derek has really done a great job, hasn't he? I mean, almost a 3-second violation in fakes.
Walker comes up. Back rims a three. Big rebound. Coleman tipped away. Picked off Grice. Looking, finds Woodard. Good fake. And it's still Villanova ball.
Whew. Well, that's the speed. You either got to make a quick fake and go up, or go up clean. And not a happy man, the maestro.
Woodard down in the blocks to Taylor. Swallowed up, but a foul is called. Dave Johnson and Tim Higgins with some quick words to Dave Johnson about histrionics after the call.
Now, this is more like a Big East game. These guys have not been jabbing and jawing with the officials. It's been very subdued.
Rodney Taylor at the free throw line. If Villanova pulls the upset here tonight, this is the game tape Rodney wants to take with him when he leaves.
It's his resume, huh, for the next level? Soft-spoken, was, as you mentioned, playing through pain throughout his career.
For Taylor. Nova by one. Under 5 minutes to play.
They haven't really run that high-low that they run so well. Well, here they go. They got Billy up high and Derek down low.
Quick double on Coleman, and Woodard's called on the reach-in foul. Four on Woodard.
Well, the philosophy very simple, huh? When it goes in, you're down and dig and scratch and try and come up with a double.
Clears the miss. Coleman, one of his last three at the line.
71% free throw shooter, too.
Yep.
If they reverse it, they've got the big guy.
Grice, little turnaround, no, and a rebound. Thompson in traffic. Still Villanova by one. Owens comes out. Thompson puts it on the floor. The fallaway jumper is well short.
Not a good one, Mike.
Walker trying to leave it. Finds Miller. Now they'll reset.
Pretty good job that time. Felt it out. Didn't see it. Regroup.
Woodard. Bryce swings for the hook.
Had the pass to Walker, too.
Sure did. Owens the rebound.
And good job by Coleman, just chucking him out a couple of steps.
Edwards looking to push, and it goes off Thompson's hands out of bounds.
Lance Miller just sort of put the hands up, face guarded. Great play.
We've got a timeout, 3:43 to go. Villanova by one. Game of Big Monday. Villanova 52, Syracuse 51. 9:30 tomorrow night. Don't forget Mississippi State and Alabama. We'll go at it after the battle between number one and number two. But we've got a battle coming up here for the final 3:40 in the first game on a Big Monday. Good trap on Woodard, but he finds Walker. Bounce pass Taylor. To the hole. Rodney for two.
Well, you've got to punish the press at some point. It'll loosen it up. And good body control by Taylor.
3-point Villanova lead. Owens held off Taylor, and then Taylor got him on the way by.
What a job gathering himself, though, as Rodney Taylor denied beautifully, made it a difficult baseline pass, but Owens with great footwork.
Only the second on Taylor. And again, the free throw line has not been kind tonight to Syracuse. They are 7 of 14. 17 for Owens.
Curious to see if they can get something out of their press or Villanova once again attacks.
Won't have the chance to find out.
Gotta nail them.
Villanova two and the ball as we approach the three-minute mark.
A new look on offense, 1-4. Little pick and roll.
Woodard comes around a screen, comes up firing, and he back rims it. Miller, a big rebound. In traffic, he gets out of it.
Pretty nice call there, the double screen for Woodard.
They try to trap Walker. Syracuse trying to trap all over the floor right now.
Not a bad move, huh? And then settle.
Edwards out on Walker. Walker behind a big Grice screen. Finds Miller with 14 on the shot clock. Lance Miller's runner Johnson got him down on the baseline.
And he got it. He turned the corner, and there's Johnson unable to seal it off. But you can really see the defense now. Syracuse trying to assert a little more pressure. Stevie Thompson trying to fight over picks on Woodard.
50% free throw shooting for Syracuse. Coleman a big night. 12-point advantage at the free throw line for the Villanova Wildcats. And Rodney Taylor, as good a game as he has played this year.
Solid.
A concerned Syracuse bench.
Talking to Jimmy before the game, it's so hard, to sit there, I said, when you're struggling on the free throw line, you almost become accustomed to it. And he said it's tough because you don't have an easy trip. You got to worry yourself and you settle one while the other guy might get three.
Short.
Miller misses a big free throw. Rowley just looking up going like, God, that's the one consistent thing we've been doing all year. Edwards, tough shot, makes it.
Did you ever expect it to be him?
First basket of the night for Michael Edwards. Up until that point, only four Syracuse players had scored in the game.
I'd like to get Grice to nice play by Steve.
Thompson keeps it alive to Edwards. Little pull up. Michael Edwards comes up with two quick ones.
Well, earlier, Michael, I mentioned Stevie Thompson did not stop guarding down here. He was fighting over picks. Gorgeous job. And come up with a big one for Syracuse.
And a quick timeout called by Rolly Massimino. 94 seconds to go in the game. 56-54. Now, I know a lot of people in Syracuse, as we look at the Villanova huddle, I know a lot of people in Syracuse have made a career of second-guessing Jim Boeheim, but he pulled the pressure off right away after the basket.
Well, I think what he's been doing, Mike, when they get ahead, he's backed it off to save the energy. I feel they've been very tired, Mike, and the only guy at times was Stevie Thompson denying, and of course it ended up a great benefit to Syracuse.
Let's take a look at some of the half-court defense and the resulting fast break.
Well, of course, they've been looking for Woodard. Usually, Grice has to start things with a kick. But right here, Stevie, actually with the incorrect hand, the right hand, he wasn't sliding in denial. Gives it up early in a good defensive play as the defense backs off. Walker forces the tougher shot. But two major league goals by Michael Edwards.
Michael Edwards there. He had Thompson and Owens, both free on the wing, and he takes the pull-up.
Well, Walker backed off, though. I mean, he almost was forced to take the shot.
Timeouts are 3 and 2. The possession hour will belong to the Wildcats, long since in the bonus situation. 1:34 to go in the game, 56-54 Syracuse. And needless to say, a critical offensive possession right now for the Villanova Wildcats. Grice, Woodard, Dowdell, Miller, and Walker are on the floor. Rodney Taylor wants to get back in the game, but won't be able to.
A 2-3 zone now, so that's going to put the stress on the outside shot. Remember the top of the key and the wing. A little flash in the lane. You see Dowdell high.
Just saw Rowley look out to Woodard and say, run it. Walker was free for a moment on the other side. That's where he was, squared up. He takes it. Hits it outside.
Well, they swung the zone one way. There goes Billy Owens, couldn't get out on time. Jimmy Boeheim now with the timeout. Pretty good ball reversal.
1:04 to go. Villanova hanging on.
Let's go.
Well, Tom Grice with a big Monday.
It has to go into him for anything to happen with this club. And of course, it's swinging the zone. They end up with the open jumper.
Here we go. Edwards finds Thompson. Manning in the game. Skips it to Owens. They want to go to Coleman down low. Grice has got him.
Edwards is taking it on his own, but it hasn't been there.
Edwards, little move, takes the shot. Manning an offensive board. Back up. No. Traveling is called.
He did. Good call. Syracuse has to be ready all out with their pressure now. J.B. Thompson trying to get everybody organized. They usually go to Grice, and he looks up the floor.
Gets it back to Lance Miller. Walker's open. They find him. Double team gets it to Miller. Woodard, not a guy you want to foul. They find Walker. In the corner, Taylor. Shot clock is off.
I would give one even at random, Michael, just to get the ball back.
I better give one soon.
Well, you get it to three. Even if they make both, it's a three-point game.
And there it is on Walker with 12 seconds to go.
A lot of time wasted.
Sure was.
And Jimmy Boeheim calling Michael Edwards over. A lot of that is reaction by the players, too.
Chris Walker, an 81% free throw shooter in Big East games this year. They're getting ready to rush the court here.
I'm going under the table if they come over.
Well, we've had some scenes before on a big Monday at the Spectrum, and we might have another one coming up.
Because each shot changes the outlook.
Villanova's going to take a timeout. 10 points for Chris Walker. 12.2 seconds to go. Villanova by two. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. If I get a national ranking, I don't want to play on Big Monday, but Michigan State will have to tonight as they take on Iowa in our second game. A chance to see Steve Smith, one of the best players in the country. And then UNC Charlotte and Long Beach State at midnight. But right now, they are going nuts in the Spectrum.
Well, Jimmy Boeheim's got timeouts, so he's in good shape in that category, Michael. But this shot now changes what you want to do. If he misses and you rebound, now you can come up and call your timeout, and it's a two-shot game. And obviously, the other way, I still think the best way to get three if he makes it is to go inside and kick it to one of your perimeter shooters.
Edwards and Owens being the options.
Right, and let them nail it.
Fine young student there.
Rather old to be an undergraduate.
Walker for the second of two. And now Syracuse is going to ice him a bit. Let's take a look at the Big East standings. And one of the things I had mentioned, we had talked about this morning, Bill, Syracuse really had their fate in their own hands, and that they have Georgetown coming to them the last game of the season. And so they didn't need anybody else to knock off the Hoyas to get a piece of the Big East regular season championship. But now, looking at their fourth loss, they do not have Connecticut again. And they will slip down in a tie with St. John's. And the team I think that you have to watch is Pittsburgh.
You like
at
that,
10
and huh?
11, yep.
I'll be able to see them tomorrow up in Pittsburgh with UConn.
Yes, and that'll be a big game for Pitt, who has a habit of making these late-season runs. You know?
But getting into this game right now, Michael, is a distinct chance, depending on the make and or the miss, as to what Syracuse wants to do. Get it up to half court, get the timeout, or run the quick one. It'll pass from baseline to half court if Villanova permits them. Now, Villanova is not on the foul line. They're just letting Walker get on and everybody else back. So if he makes it, Syracuse can get it to half court quickly unless Villanova runs up after the miss.
Do you think that hurts your free throw shooter?
Well, some kids aren't used to it. You're right. And again, a lot of guys like this because they're afraid their guy will foul. I used to like to keep the kids on there just so that they couldn't run the ball up and say, don't even go for the rebound. But the fear of the foul is the concern of the shooting team.
Villanova by two. Misses it. Two-point game. Here comes Edwards to Owens.
Should go inside and get the
leans
foul.
Leans and fires. Rebound. Lance Miller underneath, and he's fouled.
Stevie Thompson. Now, Billy Owens was pushing to get the quickie, and he had some contact, but there was time to get it down, maybe get to the foul line, dump it low, and let DC, Derek Coleman, touch it and do some magic.
Jim Boeheim trying to figure out how he can do a little magic with 3.5 seconds on the clock.
Again, a chance depending on the outcome of the free throws.
Billy Owens surveying the situation. And Lance Miller at the free throw line. Biggest free throws of his young career. It's a three-point game. Well, he makes this one, it's academic.
It's history. Well, proof of conference play. You let down a little, and somebody's going to come after you. I think he understands his team, Rolly. You know, he knows some nights you're just not going to have it come up empty. And some nights, very tough.
There it is. Michael Edwards heaves it up. The Villanova Wildcats have knocked off the fourth-ranked team in the country, 60-56 on a big Monday. They are loving it here in Philadelphia. Final score once again from the Spectrum. That's a happy guy right there. 60-56. Nova knocks off Syracuse. Back to you, John.
Mike and Bill, Rolly Massimino tightening up the ties. He gets ready for the post-game interview. A four-point win, and more importantly, a sweep over Syracuse in the season. They got them when they were number one, and they got them tonight when they were number four. Now, tonight we still have two games to come here on Big Monday. We will move to the Big Ten in just a few moments' time. Number 21, Michigan State, trying to avoid the upset at Iowa. Iowa's already knocked off Illinois and Michigan at home. After SportsCenter, we'll come back at midnight with the Battle of the 49ers, UNC Charlotte, and Long Beach State. So stay with us. Plenty more basketball to come here on Big Monday. We already have one upset. Could another one be on the way? Stay with us.